Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, fire, 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 fire.
I command them to the abyss.
I command them to the abyss.
Say, God Almighty, you are holy.
God Almighty, you are holy.
You are wonderful.
You are wonderful.
You are glorious.
You are glorious.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
You are God of Abraham.
You are God of Abraham.
God of Isaac.
God of Isaac.
God of Jacob.
God of Jacob.
I worship you.
I worship you.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are my Lord.
You are my Lord.
You are my Savior.
You are my Savior.
Wash me with your blood.
Wash me with your blood.
Forgive me my sins.
Forgive me my sins.
Bless me today.
Bless me today.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are the Alpha.
You are the Alpha.
The Omega.
The Omega.
The King of Kings.
The King of Kings.
The Lords of Lords.
The Lord of Lords.
Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Counselor.
Counselor.
Mighty God.
Mighty God.
Everlasting Father.
Everlasting Father.
I worship you.
I worship you.
Say, wonderful Holy Ghost.
Wonderful Holy Ghost.
I surrender to you.
I surrender to you.
I open my heart.
I open my heart.
I open my spirit.
I open my spirit.
Teach me your word.
Teach me your word.
Reveal to me.
Reveal to me.
Your divine revelations.
Your divine revelations.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
The Bible says that where two or three comes together in my name, the Bible says that Jesus Christ said that, there I am in their midst. And also tonight, Jesus Christ is here, the Holy Ghost is here, God Almighty is here, angels are here, and we'll have a privilege to sing unto God tonight. Let us get ready to sing unto God tonight.
Everybody just stand right now, everybody. We just want you to know. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Lila.
together on the word of testimony tonight.
Amen. Our testimony reads as follows. Pain in the stomach here. There is a woman from Mozambique who called for prayer. She had been suffering from a pain in her stomach for more than a week. She had gone to the hospital, but the pain didn't go away, even after consultation. The man of God prayed for her over the phone, and the power of God touched her. She confirmed that she was feeling heat all over her body as the man of God prayed for her. She testified that the pain has left her body after prayer. Glory to God in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Our announcements are as follows. Every morning at 6 a.m. from Monday to Friday, we have our morning prayer, which is at 7 a.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. Our midday service starts at 5 to 12, and then we have our evening service, which starts at 6 p.m. every night. Our midnight prayer starts at 5 to 12 every night, and we also have our weekly prayer and fasting, which is on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. The details of the fasting are shared on our different WhatsApp groups. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight, we will read the word of God from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 20, from verse 30, NIV. It reads as follows. Saul's anger flared up at Jonathan, and he said to him, "You son of a perverse and rebellious woman, don't I know that you have sided with the son of Jesse to your own shame and to the shame of the mother who bore you? As long as the son of Jesse lives on this earth, neither you nor your kingdom will be established. Now send someone to bring him to me, for he must die. Why should he be put to death? What has he done?" Jonathan asked his father. But Saul hurled his spear at him to kill him. Then Jonathan knew that his father intended to kill David. Jonathan got up from the table in fierce anger. On that second day of the feast, he did not eat because he was grieved at his father's shameful treatment of David. In the morning, Jonathan went out to the field for his meeting with David. He had a small boy with him, and he said to the boy, "Run and find the arrows I shoot." As the boy ran, he shot an arrow beyond him. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Also tonight, we will have a privilege to go through the Word of God together, believing the Word of God to be taught with power. Power of the Holy Spirit, power to heal, power to bless, power to protect in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let us go through the Word of God from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 20, verse number 30. The Bible says that Saul's anger flared up at Jonathan, and he said to him, "You son of perverse and a rebellious woman, don't you know that you have sided? Don't I know that you have sided with the son of Jesse to your own shame and to the shame of the mother who bore you?" You know, the Bible is talking about, this is after when Saul was asking for David. As he's asking for David, the Bible says that because David has begun to see the plans that Saul have, that Saul want to kill him. But this time he have tried to convince a Jonathan. To say, "Jonathan, it is as if your father want to kill him." And when he have said so, that it is as if his soul want to kill him, Jonathan was not really aware of it. Then when he was not aware of it, he wanted some confirmation to say that, "Oh no, I want to see whether Saul really want to kill you." I want to see where the soul is not really happy with you. Then they make an arrangement, because David was someone who was close to the king also, in such a way that in a daily basis he will be there in the dinner table. Then for 2 days David was meant not to be there, and they wanted to find out what was in the heart of Saul. What is it that Saul was planning against David? They wanted to find out what was Saul's intention. Is it true that Saul wanted to kill David? Then they make that arrangement. And the Bible says that they've agreed that David must go and hide. And they will do this thing to test, to find out what is in the heart of Saul. And once they found out if David is safe, there will be a signal. If David is not safe, there will be a signal. But they wanted to confirm protecting David so that there can never be a harm to David.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, sometimes it's important to find out who is plotting against you.
Amen.
Sometimes it's important that your enemy be unmasked.
Amen.
You know, sometimes when you are running blind and you don't know what the enemies are planning against you, you might think that things are well. You might think that things are normal until your enemy is planning you and is planning to kill you. Sometimes it is important for the trap to be exposed.
Amen.
Sometimes it's important for the enemy to be exposed.
Amen.
So that when the enemy has been exposed, you will know how to react. You will know what to do. For example, if Saul was not unmasked, if Saul was not exposed, and David stayed in this banquet table or this dinner table, David was going to be killed. At the end of it, David was going to be killed. But now when Saul's intentions are exposed, then David and Jonathan, now they can plan accordingly and they can make a decision to say, David, I think you must really just go. David, you must really just go so that you can save your life. It's the same thing, you know, when you're talking about in the Word of God, the Bible talks about, you know, for example, the Bible talks about the birth of Jesus Christ. When the Bible talks about the birth of Jesus Christ, the Bible says that on the birth of Jesus Christ, there was a star that appeared. When that star appeared, it was the star directing the wise men to where Jesus Christ was born. And the Bible says that star directed them, wise men from the east, from all over. And on their way to go to where Jesus Christ was born, they tend to think, okay, if now this is a prophetic word that has been said that a king is about to be born, maybe the king is born in the palace. And the Bible said that they pass through Herod and they inquire, is it here where the star, where God is directing us? Is it here where the son of, where the new king has been born? And the Bible said that Herod said that he did not know anything about it. Well, he did not know anything about it. He said that if you find this king that you're talking about in the land, please tell me. Please tell me. And the Bible said they went, they followed the star. That's what they were supposed to do. They were just supposed to follow the star, not to pass through Herod's house, not to pass through Herod's palace. And the Bible said that yes, they passed. And once they have passed, they went to Bethlehem. And they found the baby born in the manger. And there the Bible said that that night the Bible said that Joseph had a dream. Before the dream, it was the dream that God gave them a vision, a dream that they must not go back. They must not go back to Herod. They must use the different way, because Herod does not have a good intention. Herod is acting as if he has got a good intention. He wants to see where the child is born. But he doesn't really want to see where the child is born. He wants to kill the child. Then now, you see, now when they now have a revelation to show that Herod does not have a good intention, they now plan accordingly and they use a different way when the enemy is exposed.
Amen.
When the enemy have been unmasked.
Amen.
And Jesus' life was saved.
Amen.
And the Bible said that after that, the angel appeared again. Joseph had a dream and God told him that no, Herod want to kill your son. Because now Herod want to kill your son, you must go to Egypt. And the Bible said that Herod took baby Jesus and he went to Egypt and baby Jesus was saved. It was when the enemy is in unmasked. I'm talking to somebody today. Sometimes because an enemy is not an unmasked, an enemy look like a friend. An enemy look innocent. You may be playing with a snake. You may be playing with a Delilah. You may be eating with a Judas. You may be planning with a rattlesnake. You may be planning with a wicked enemy who is acting innocent but planning wickedness to finish your life, to finish your career, to finish your things. But you are just not aware. Sometimes it's important that the enemy must be unmasked. Soul must be exposed. So that you can act accordingly.
Amen.
I'm talking to somebody tonight. I'm saying whoever is your planning any bad against you, let them be exposed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let them be exposed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to tell you this.
Amen.
It was not so easy for Saul to speak the way he has spoken. He is speaking the way he's spoken. He's speaking now because he is arrested. And the intention of the enemy is getting exposed. He's manifesting. I'm saying to you tonight, I don't know who I'm talking tonight. You know, I may be talking to you tonight. I may be taking to you next year. I may be taking to you year after next year. I may be taking to you at the right time, at the right moment. But I'm speaking to somebody. I'm saying to you, your enemy will manifest in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Mark my words. Amen. The Bible said that whatever we bind here on earth is bound in heaven.
Amen.
Some people who are planning evil like you, don't be surprised when they manifest.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
It will be because they will be arrested by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Like what you are hearing here.
Amen.
The Bible says that Saul's anger fled up at Jonathan and said, something was stirred in Saul. He could not control himself. and he said that, you son of perverse, a rebellious and a rebellious woman, don't you know that you have sided with the son of Jesse to your own shame and to the shame of the mother who bore you? Saul's intention and the enemy's intention against David are being exposed. And Saul is talking uncontrollably. I don't know who is the witch. I don't know who is a wicked person, who the demon and the devil has possessed, who look innocent like a beautiful Delilah. Delilah was dangerous woman who was destined to arrest one of the greatest men of the Bible by the name of Samson. This woman, she looks very beautiful. This woman looks very innocent. In which the Bible says that Samson feels like he got a wife. He got a wife. He rely on this woman. He trusts on this woman. She acts innocent, but she's conspiring with his enemies, trying to come out with the strategies to arrest him, trying to come up with the strategies to find out what is the secret of his power, so that they can extinguish that power and arrest Samson and finish him up.
Amen.
But Samson is not aware. Samson is relaxing in the lap of Delilah. Samson is not aware. He's sharing all the secrets with Delilah. Sharing all the secrets.
Amen.
With this woman who is the agent of darkness. Sometimes we meet people whom we don't know who they are.
Amen.
Can't some people have got a wicked agenda to finish our lives?
Amen.
They look beautiful. The makeup look beautiful. The friend who you trust. Somebody who you share your secrets. Somebody like Delilah, sometimes it's some wicked people who act innocently in certain rank, who is acting as if all things are well, but they are conspiring evil against you. I'm saying to you, I don't know who's that wicked person. Let them be exposed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Any Delilah in our horizon, let them be exposed in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They will manifest. Amen. As Saul have manifested in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm talking to somebody. I'm saying that demon will speak in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That witch will speak in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That wicked personality will speak in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What I'm talking about, you will see it with your own eyes.
Amen.
You will hear it with your own ears.
Amen.
If it takes for it to be a dream, some you must see them in your dreams.
Amen.
The witch must be unmasked.
Amen.
Evil person must be unmasked.
Amen.
They must be exposed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We are not going to walk blind in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That's why that day the Bible says that in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 20 verse number 31, as long as the son of Jesse lives on earth, neither you nor your kingdom will be established. Now send someone to bring him to me, for he must die. Now Saul is speaking what is in his heart. Jonathan did not know about it.
Amen.
But Saul is being exposed that he wants to kill David.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Saul is being exposed that he's not looking for David to be in the dinner table to enjoy feast with him. But he wants David to be there so that he can kill him. I'm saying to you, like what you're talking about, Herod. Herod speaks as if he wants to see Jesus, but he doesn't want to see Jesus. He wants to kill Jesus.
Amen.
He wants to kill Jesus, but he has been unmasked.
Amen.
I'm saying to you, child of God, there will be nothing that your enemy will ever plan that you will not know in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
By the power of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Our enemies will be exposed.
Amen.
Our enemies and their plans will be exposed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
They will manifest in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I speak to somebody's life. I'm saying that no weapon fashioned against us shall prosper in Jesus' name.
Amen.
No plan of the enemy will ever come to pass in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we'll be going forward in this book of the book of 1 Samuel, you are about to hear that even the plans of Saul never come to pass.
Amen.
Against David.
Amen.
Even the plans of Herod never came to pass against Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So the plans of our enemies will never come to pass in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They will plan, but they will never come to pass.
Amen.
I'm saying to those who are planning against us, who are planning against you, may the angels of God appear to that council and give them confusion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Some people who are planning against you, from now on, they will begin to disagree in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I don't know whether I'm talking to somebody.
Amen.
If you don't believe it, say back to the sender. But I came to you with this message. It's a prophetic word which God wants to deal with certain situation in somebody's life.
Amen.
With certain things in somebody's life.
Amen.
To rectify things that were going wrong, that the enemy have been playing and planning as they wish. But I'm here to speak to you this evening. I'm saying to you, enough is enough.
Amen.
Whatever the enemy have planned against any one of us, they're canceled in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We will not die before our time.
Amen.
You will not die before your time.
Amen.
You will not lose your job. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Angels are appearing everywhere. They are talking against any one of us.
Amen.
And cause the stories to change for our good in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are the child of God.
Amen.
The enemy will not play in your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Anyone who will try to be against any one of us will never win in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Everything will turn around for your good in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know, when you are following this very well, you can see that Jonathan and his father were supposed to agree.
Amen.
Remember, if you are hearing this very well, if you are hearing this very well, his father is saying that as long as son of Jesse lives on this earth, neither you, Jonathan, No, your kingdom will be established. I'm not, Saul is saying, I'm not doing these things for myself. I'm doing these things for you, Jonathan. Jonathan, he's saying to Jonathan, he's not fighting David for himself. But he have realized that God is with Amen. David. And because God is with David, he Amen. Have realized that it is impossible for David to become nobody.
Amen.
It is impossible for David to remain nobody.
Amen.
At the end of the day, David is going Amen. To be a king.
Amen.
At the end of the day, David is going to be big. Child of God, sometimes the enemy,
Amen.
When you see an enemy fighting you, the enemy does not just fight anybody.
Amen.
In the kingdom of darkness, they have seen Amen. That you are big.
Amen.
That you are great.
Amen.
Saul is fighting Amen. David because he has realized David is big.
Amen.
No matter what, David is going to be
Amen.
Great.
Amen.
Then sometimes you find, you look at the challenges around your life. You look at the challenges around your things Amen. And you wonder why. Why me? Why is this one having it easy? Why is this one getting it easy? Why me? Why do I have to struggle so much? Why is Saul fighting Amen. David other than any other soldier? It was not as if it was only David who Amen. Was sitting there. There were many others, but David, Saul saw that David is not an ordinary man. He is anointed to be great.
Amen.
Sometimes the enemy have seen Amen. That you are destined to be great.
Amen.
That's why the enemy Amen. Is after you.
Amen.
He knows that you are not ordinary.
Amen.
Let me tell you this. It's the same thing in the life of Jesus. Why is Herod against this baby? There are many babies at the time. But Herod was against this baby in such a way that after when Jesus and his family have left to Egypt, Herod ordered unknowingly to kill all the firstborn of his time. And not to kill all Amen. The firstborn of Israel, because he knew that this is not the ordinary child.
Amen.
Sometimes the reason why, Amen. The reason of your struggle is a symbol of your destiny.
Amen.
Why?
Amen.
Others are getting promoted and the enemy is holding you down. Why others are getting employed and it seems as if your things are not moving? Why? Sometimes the enemy have seen that you are a destined child.
Amen.
Destined child of your family.
Amen.
A destined breed.
Amen.
The one who God is going to manifest Amen. Through.
Amen.
The one who's going to tithe.
Amen.
The one who's going to be faithful Amen. In working with. He knows that, hey, you are blessed. When money comes to your hand, you don't only think about me, myself, and I, but you think about the kingdom. That's why he's fighting you so much.
Amen.
Don't be discouraged.
Amen.
Enemy is not fighting you because you are nobody.
Amen.
He doesn't, you know, it, this thing Amen. Is the same thing at the soccer ball. They don't chase someone without a ball.
Amen.
They chase someone who is Amen. Having a ball.
Amen.
Then child of God, hold Amen. On unto God. Don't give up.
Amen.
Imagine if David gave up and say, look, even the king is after me. David must not give up.
Amen.
It's just because Saul have
Amen.
Seen that he's tomorrow's king.
Amen.
And I was still telling you.
Amen.
Then if you read very well, Jesse and his son were supposed to agree. Because Saul is doing these things for Jonathan.
Amen.
But no, God was on David's side, making sure that they don't agree. I'm talking to somebody tonight. I don't know who are the enemies. I don't know who are the witches. I don't know on which council which they are talking and plotting against you. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to that council tonight as I'm standing in the presence of God.
Amen.
And I'm saying to you, from today, anyone who will speak against us, who will plot against us, they will never agree in Jesus' name.
Amen.
They will never agree in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Whenever they plan against any one of us, the Holy Ghost will appear and cause confusion.
Amen.
Angels of God will appear and cause confusion.
Amen.
As long as they will be planning against any one of us,
amen,
they will know that, hey, you are a different breed.
Amen.
You are the child of the Almighty God.
Amen.
Why do you have to suffer with the greater I am?
Amen.
Why do we have to suffer when you are praying so much?
Amen.
It's time to use the authority.
Amen.
It's time to use power.
Amen.
Power is not only falling and rising.
Amen.
This is what you're going to hear about power.
Amen.
And to show that God have done it, by the power of the Holy Ghost, you will overhear what they were planning.
Amen.
But you will hear about their confusion afterwards.
Amen.
To say the moment they speak your name, amen, this one begin to speak this point this way.
Amen.
Another one pull it this way.
Amen.
And it never stood.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
We serve a miracle-working God. We serve a miracle-working God. Oh, I serve a wonder. I serve a miracle-working God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
David was serving a great God.
Amen.
That's why the two could not agree. And we are serving the living God.
Amen.
That's why anyone who will plot against us will never agree.
Amen.
If they want to scatter their table,
amen,
to scatter their things, amen, let them plot against us.
Amen.
They will see that we are the child of the greater I am.
Amen.
Wonder-working God.
Amen.
You know, sometimes we'll be doing deliverance.
Amen.
As we're doing deliverance, you will find that they will be saying that, you know, the name of that one. Which name? The name of that one. Who's that one? They don't want to say the name of Jesus Christ. Because if they mention the name of Jesus Christ, their things scatter.
Amen.
As a child of the living God,
amen,
that name we carry it.
Amen.
Anyone who will mention your name, plot against, amen, any of us, their things will scatter in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
After these powerful prayers and declaration and prophecies mentioned and spoken over your life, over our everything, I want you to go and pray,
amen,
enforcing it. And very soon you will come back with a testimony.
Amen.
You will come back with a proof to, amen, say, hey, this one just came and begin to expose themselves.
Amen.
Can I tell you, amen, in the kingdom of darkness,
amen,
whatever they plot, it is meant to be done in darkness for it never to be found.
Amen.
But a witch, if you wake up in your yard and you see a witch naked, it means that witch have been arrested.
Amen.
If a witch can come and begin to say, hey, I am a witch. Hey, they are devil worshippers. Know that they are arrested.
Amen.
I'm saying this because there are people who are going to be arrested.
Amen.
By the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And they will speak what they have planned against you.
Amen.
Either in anger or in another manifestation, but the fact is that whoever will plot against any one of us, there is a declaration and angels sent out.
Amen.
Who are going to make sure that what you are talking about, you see it with your eyes.
Amen.
You hear it with your ears.
Amen.
Begin to pray wherever you are. Begin to pray. Begin to pray. Arakashaki Kokoshi. Karakanyo. Mando Lokosha. Karabashiki. Karakasho Koroboka. Pariakaido. Merebe. Parabe. Erebe Shekere Bakatoroko. Karawaye. Shandalaba Shekere Baba. Barabai Katoroko Shekere Baba. Barababa Baba Yekerebe. Katokoroko She. Rakin Tonto Bakatarake. Let all our enemies be exposed. Let all the plans of the enemy be cancelled. Cancelled and be exposed. Agent of darkness against us, let them be exposed. Ora kashaka. You are the great God. You are the mighty God. The one who's our great defender. Defend us in every way. Let no weapon forged against us prosper. Never let them prosper. Never let them agree. Those who are plotting against us, May they scatter. Holy Ghost, fire.
I command them to the abyss.
Where they are conspiring against us. Fire.
I command them to the abyss.
Say anything which is not of God.
In my life. In my body.
In my career.
In my career.
In our countries.
In our countries.
In every sectors of our life.
In every sectors of our life.
Catch fire now.
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 I command
them.
Come out.
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 Say I command.
I command
everything to turn around for my good.
Everything to turn around for my good.
Say everything.
Everything.
Turn around.
Turn around.
For our good.
For our good.
Say let there be progress.
Let there be progress.
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 In every sectors of my life.
In every sectors of my life.
In every sectors of our life.
In every sectors of our life.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Say all is well.
All is well.
All is well.
All is well.
In my life.
In my life.
In our life.
In our life.
In our families,
in our families,
in our careers,
in our careers,
in our studies,
in our studies,
in our finances,
in our finances.
Say all is well,
all is well,
all is well, in the name of Jesus Christ,
in the name of Jesus Christ,
in the name of Jesus Christ.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are my Lord.
You are my Lord.
You are my Savior.
You are my Savior.
Wash me with your blood.
Wash me with your blood.
Forgive me my sins.
Forgive me my sins.
Bless me today.
Bless me today.
Protect me from today.
Protect me from today.
With your power.
With your power.
Of the Holy Spirit.
Of the Holy Spirit.
From today.
From today.
I am born again.
I am born again.
I am saved.
I am saved.
Say may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
The love of God.
The love of God.
The fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
The fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
Be with us all.
Be with us all.
Surely goodness and love.
Surely goodness and love.
Shall follow me.
Shall follow me.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
And I dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
And I dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
I dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are continuing to pray. We are continuing to fast. Today is day number 18 of 21. And in this season, we are planting a seed. This ministry is fasting the offering of these 21 days. Plant a seed. Find a ministry where you can plant a seed. And I can assure you, you will not come back empty-handed.
Amen.
We serve a living God.
Amen.
We serve a mighty God.
Amen.
A prayer-answering God.
Amen.
At the end of it, you will come back with your testimony.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. And I want to say to us tonight, may God bless you. Have a blessed and a wonderful night in Jesus' name.
Bye-bye, everybody. Have a blessed morning, day, and afternoon, and night.
Amen. Bye-bye.
Amen. Bye.
Bye.